Welcome one and welcome all. No matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, no matter what rock you crawled out from under or what cemetery you haunt, you are welcome here in this place, though you may never leave. Especially if you join the church and join a board and work on some subcommittees. You're in for a spectacular and spooky night, but I have a few announcements to share with you first. Many of you, I hope, have these orange cards. This is a game we're playing during the concert called Name That Tune. It's set up like a bingo card, but that's not what it is. Name That Tune. So, if you see something on here that you think you hear tonight, mark it off. And they're not all the same, so if you hear something that you don't see on here, write it in. At the end, there will be prizes for those who correctly identify the most tunes. Okay? Then, there is also, and I'm so thrilled to see so many of you dressed up in your finest, there will be a costume contest. Now, I think we said that everyone got a prize, but so many of you are dressed up, it's overwhelming. I don't know if that happened. But there will be a costume contest. You'll receive instructions about that. It will happen later in the program. It will involve some sort of parade, one imagines, near the front. Okay? Now, you may have noticed I'm killing time just a little bit. That's because, one, I'm waiting for the sun to go down just a little bit. And also, we can't find our organist. I have a theory, though. It is the witching hour, and I think she's stuck in broom traffic. But never fear, or perhaps you should always be afraid. We have another way we can start the concert, but I need your help. I need your participation because this is a magical and unusual night. I happen to have pulled off of one wizard a magic wand, but I need your help because I'm not a wizard. I'm obviously Milford Brimley, right? So together we can say an incantation that will make our organs sing. That incantation is Organum Cantorum, or sing organ. So practice that with me. Organum Cantorum. Organum Cantorum. Very good. Now, if you do it right, and if you really believe, we can start the concert. Okay? So on three, Organum Cantorum. Ready? One, two, three. Organum Cantorum. I know the mic's on, so that wasn't it. You really have to believe. You really got to buy. I mean, that was pretty good. I was impressed, I'm not gonna lie. One more time, really put it into it, okay? I know that the little thing lights up at the end if you do it right, okay? One, two, three. Organum Cantorum. Aha!
What's this? There's color everywhere. What's this? There's white things in the air. What's this? I can't believe my eyes. I must be dreaming. Wake up, Jack. This isn't fair. What's this?
Your sisters will be what is the meanest kind of world. If I were on this leaves on the trees turn brown and fall off the branches. Pumpkins grow big and plump in their patches.
The air grows cooler, and people start to think about their Halloween costumes. And every fall, Linus writes a very important letter.
Dear Great Pumpkin, I'm looking forward to your arrival on Halloween night. I hope you will bring me lots of presents.
Who on earth are you writing a letter to?
The Great Pumpkin. On Halloween night, the Great Pumpkin rises out of his pumpkin patch and flies through the air with his bag of toys for all children.
Linus' sister, Lucy, isn't happy that Linus is riding the Great Pumpkin.
You and your Great Pumpkin make me the laughingstock of the neighborhood,
she complains. But Charlie Brown's sister, Sally, doesn't think Linus is crazy. She thinks Linus is wonderful.
You are my sweet baboo.
Wouldn't you like to sit with me on the pumpkin patch on Halloween night and wait for the Great Pumpkin?
I'd love to.
Later that day, Charlie Brown has a surprise waiting for him at the mailbox.
I got an invitation to a Halloween party.
Lucy thinks the invitation must be a mistake.
There were two lists, one to invite and one not to invite.
Charlie Brown knows which list he was probably on, but he decides to go to the party anyway.
On Halloween night, everyone is planning to go to the party.
Except Linus.
My blockhead brother will be out in that pumpkin patch all by himself, making a fool of himself again this year,
Lucy grumbles. She can't understand why Linus would choose to miss out on all the fun that Halloween has to offer by sitting around in a pumpkin patch.
Everyone puts on their costume.
Lucy is dressed as a witch.
Charlie Brown is dressed as a ghost, but no one can tell what he is supposed to be because he had some trouble with the scissors.
Sally is also dressed as a ghost, but she figured out how to use the scissors just fine.
Snoopy walks by, also dressed in a costume.
Don't you know? He's a World War I flying ace.
Now I've seen everything.
Then Lucy declares that everyone will go trick-or-treating first, and then go to the Halloween party.
As they pass by the pumpkin patch, Linus sees them and gets excited, thinking they have all come to wait with him.
Have you come to sing pumpkin carols with me?
You blockhead! You're going to miss all the fun just like last year.
Don't talk like that. The Great Pumpkin will come because I am in the most sincere pumpkin patch.
Oh, good grief.
It looks like no one wants to join Linus in the pumpkin patch to wait for the Great Pumpkin.
Except, what about Sally?
Sally is torn. She doesn't want to miss out on all the fun of trick-or-treating and a party, but Linus is her sweet baboo.
Sally runs back to the pumpkin patch.
I'm glad you came back. You'll see the Great Pumpkin with your own eyes.
Linus is positive the Great Pumpkin will pick this patch, and why wouldn't he?
The Great Pumpkin chooses the most sincere patch to visit every year. And how could a pumpkin patch be more sincere than this one?
Sally hopes Linus is right. Meanwhile, the rest of the kids go trick-or-treating.
Trick-or-treats, money or eats,
they yell at the first door.
Everyone compares what they got.
I got 5 pieces of candy.
I got a rock.
And that happens at every door.
All the other kids get wonderful treats like candy and popcorn balls.
And Charlie Brown gets rocks.
Lucy decides they have done enough trick-or-treating and it's time to go to the party. After all, everyone has a bag full of treats.
Everyone except Charlie Brown. He has a bag full of rocks.
On the way to the party, they pass by the pumpkin patch again. The kids laugh at Linus and Sally waiting for the great pumpkin instead of coming to the party.
The great pumpkin will be here.
After the kids walk by, Sally turns to Linus.
All right, where is he?
He'll be here.
I hope so. Think of all the fun we're missing.
And the Halloween party is a lot of fun for everyone except Charlie Brown.
At first, Charlie Brown thinks his night is looking up when the other kids ask him to be the model for the jack-o'-lantern.
This sounds like a great honor.
But then he realizes that being the model means having Peppermint Patty draw a big pumpkin face on the back of his head.
Meanwhile, in the pumpkin patch, Sally is growing tired of waiting for the great pumpkin.
If anyone had told me I'd be waiting in a pumpkin patch on Halloween night, I would have said they were crazy.
Just then, she and Linus hear a great rumbling noise. They see a shadow emerging from the pumpkin patch.
It's the great pumpkin rising out of the pumpkin patch.
He is so excited to see the great pumpkin that he faints.
But it isn't the great pumpkin after all. It's just the World War I flying ace on his way back from a very important mission. Linus wakes up and asks Sally what happened.
I was robbed. Halloween is over and I missed it.
She stomps out of the pumpkin patch, leaving Linus all alone to wait for the great pumpkin.
Linus falls asleep waiting. Later that night, Lucy comes to bring him home and tuck him into his warm bed.
The next day, Charlie Brown tries to make Linus feel better.
Don't take it too hard that the great pumpkin never showed up.
But Linus doesn't feel let down at all.
Just wait till next year. I'll find the most sincere pumpkin patch, and I'll sit in that pumpkin patch until the great pumpkin appears.
The end.
Thank you.
it's time for our costume contest. So I'd like our pastors, they're our judges tonight, so if you don't win, take it up with them. So I would like our pastors to come forward. And what I think we're going to do is, I wonder if we have you right here, and then we're going to have all of you that want to be considered for the costume contest. We would like you to go from one end to the other. Okay? So can you kind of come up and around, and then we'd like you to do this. I'm not being considered, but if I was, I'd do this. Okay, so do we have Pastor Jack still in here? Come on, come on, come on. All right, so what I would like to do, are you guys all doing the costume contest? Okay, come on over here with me. Come on over here with me. Anybody else, come on over here. Come on over here. Come on over here. You're gonna follow me, okay? You're gonna follow me. Come on over here, folks. Oh my gosh, I am so impressed. Wow. So, if you could come over here to the side, that would be great. Make your way over here to the side so that we can have a parade. We're gonna have a parade, okay? You like parades? Okay, so everybody's gonna follow me. So everybody come on over here if you wanna be considered. Come on over here. And I'm gonna lead everybody on a parade. How about that? Okay, come on over here. So here, are you giving us some music? All right, here we go. We're gonna start the parade. Are you ready? Okay. All right, follow me. We're gonna take it a little slow so that everybody can see you. Look at this. Look at all of this. Smile, smile up here, smile. All right, we're gonna walk this way so that everybody can see us. And you can wave at everybody as you go by. See, they're waving at you. Wow, look at this. Look at all of these beautiful costumes. It's your dad! He's up there! Hi, Dad! Oh, hello! Look at all these costumes! Hello, everyone! Hello! 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 It's Snoopy. We're gonna go down the middle aisle now. Here we go! Friends, smile and wave, friends, yay! go back and sit with them. How about that? And parents, if you don't want them, I'll take them for a while. It's okay. They can stay with me. Thank you.
thank yous before we end the evening. Special thanks to our youth handbell choir who played the bell parts for. Special thanks to our lovely choir here. None of this could have been possible without our media team back in the balcony. And special thanks to our youth and specifically led by Susan Waller in setting the space for this very spooky evening. And of course, the star for the evening, our spooky, witchy organist, Sohee Lee. How about one more?
Darkness falls across the land. The midnight hour is close at hand. The foulest stench is in the air. The funk of 40,000 years. And grisly ghouls from every tomb are closing in to seal your doom. Though you fight to stay alive, your body starts to shiver, for no mere mortal can resist the evil hand of Thriller. Ho, 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 ho.